To make us understand his teaching well, Jesus gives this example in presenting a father who has two sons, who goes to the first son and asks him to go to the vineyard. And he says, "I will not." But later, who changes his mind and attends to the request of the father and goes to the vineyard. Whereas the second son, who was also being asked by the father, says, "I will go," but doesn't. 2 days back, we have heard of John the Baptist, how people repented. They felt that they were doing something wrong, or their life needs to be changed, or that they can still embrace a better life. And they asked, "What should we do?" And I have mentioned in my reflection how we constantly need to ask, "What should I do?" Or, "What more should I get in my life? What else could I accomplish? Or what else God is asking of me?" God will have different answers for us. There will be different requests for us. And it's not enough that we just ask. Do we get to that end when we accomplish whatever is being asked of us? Do we get to that final stage of what God is requesting and asking of us to get in our life? Few days back, in the weekday's gospel, we reflected how Jesus mentions that those who call me Lord, Lord, will not enter the kingdom of heaven. And we had gone further to explain how someone who hears his words and acts on them is like a wise man who built his house on a rock. Whereas the one who only hears and not acts is like a foolish one who builds a house on the sand and which has not much strong foundation. And we hear this repeated again today. How that acting, how that doing is important in our life. It's not enough that we just hear. It's not enough that we just ask, "What should we do?" There is need that we get in action-oriented life. Many of us would be so faithful to have our religious practices, to go to the church, or those who profess other faiths, to go to our own sacred places, to hear our priests, to hear our leaders, and we feel so nice. And that would be something of that first stage, like that second son, and something of that second stage, like that first son. The first son accomplishes after that repentance. He feels that he has not given the right answer and changes his mind, changes his decision, and takes on something practical. At times, and most of the times, we feel so comfortable in listening and just hearing the words, not getting into that action life. We may be so content to hear, to profess our faith, to say that I believe in this, I profess this, this is what our faith says. But when it comes to our real practical life, do we remember that profession of faith? Do we really believe that God is with us? Do we really go to the extent of trusting that God? We have all different type of people around us. We have people who speak great, who talk great, and we also have people who do great things. As we prepare for this Christmas, no matter which faith we belong to, no matter whether we don't have any faith or have any belief system or any religious identity, can we take the example of Joseph, known to be the father of Jesus? He did great work, raised up the family, raised up Jesus together with Mary, but we don't hear even one word that is being noted in the Bible. Great man with great responsibility doesn't speak a lot. Let him be our example. That things don't matter unless we do them Profession doesn't matter unless we act on them. Our promises doesn't matter. All the speeches doesn't matter unless we do it. Let us be people of doing. Let us be people of acting. And God will bless us.